Yhdysvaltain presidentin vaaliehdokkaat Donald Trump ja Joe Biden kohtasivat toisessa vaaliväittelyssä viimeisen kerran ennen vaaleja. Edellisessä väittelyssä varsinkin Trump puhui jatkuvasti Bidenin päälle, jonka seurauksena mikrofonit suljettiin nyt toisen ehdokkaan puheenvuoron ajaksi. Jos edellinen väittely pääsi unohtumaan, suosittelemme katsomaan sen linkistä ensin. 5. Koronaviruksesta tuli odotetusti jälleen iso teema vaaliväittelyssä. Yhdysvallat ovat edelleen eniten koronaviruksesta kärsinyt valtio koko maailmassa. Tästä syystä Trump yritti kääntää koronaviruskeskustelun talouskeskusteluksi.
We closed up the greatest economy in the world in order to fight this horrible disease that came from China. Choice. We can't lock ourselves up in a basement like Joe does. He has the ability to lock himself up. I don't know. He's obviously made a lot of money someplace, but he has this thing about living in a basement. People can't do that. By the way, I, as the president, couldn't do that. I'd love to put myself in the basement or in a beautiful room in the White House and go away for a year and a half until it disappears. I can't do that. And we can't close up our nation, or you're not going to have a nation.
He says that we're learning to live with it. People are learning to die with it.
I take full responsibility. It's not my fault that he came here. It's China's fault. And you know what? It's not Joe's fault that he came here either. It's China's fault. They kept it from going into the rest of China for the most part, but they didn't keep it from coming out to the world, including Europe and ourselves.
Teachers and families.
I want to open the schools. The transmittal rate to the teachers is very small. You can't do this. We can't keep this country closed. This is a massive country with a massive economy. People are losing their jobs. They're committing suicide. There's depression, alcohol, drugs at a level that nobody's ever seen before.
And by the way, all you teachers out there, not that many of you are going to die, so don't worry about it.
4. Trump sanoi Bidenin ilmastopolitiikan maksavan satoja miljardeja ja tuhoavan öljyteollisuuden. Biden sanoi, että hänen ilmastopolitiikassaan luovuttaisiin asteittain öljyteollisuudesta.
So we have the Trillion Trees program. We have so many different programs. I do love the environment, but what I want is the cleanest, crystal clear water, the cleanest air. We have the best, lowest number in carbon emission. Look at China. How filthy it is. Look at Russia. Look at India. It's filthy. The air is filthy. The Paris Accord, I took us out because we were going to have to spend trillions of dollars and we were treated very unfairly. When they put us in there, they did us a great disservice. They were going to take away our businesses. I will not sacrifice.
Climate change and climate warming, global warming, is an existential threat to humanity.
Their real plan costs $100 trillion. If we had the best year in the history of our country for 100 years, we would not even come close to a number like that. When he says buildings, they want to take buildings down because they want to make bigger windows into smaller windows. As far as they're concerned, if you had no window, it would be a lovely thing. This is the craziest plan that anybody has ever seen.
He thinks wind causes cancer, windmills. It's the fastest growing jobs, and they pay good prevailing wages.
Would you close down the oil industry?
By the way, I would transition from the oil industry, yes.
Oh,
I will transition. It is a big statement.
That's a big
statement. Because I would stop.
Why would you do that?
Because the oil industry pollutes significantly.
Oh. He was against fracking. He said it. I will show that to you tomorrow. I am against fracking. Until he got the nomination, went to Pennsylvania, then he said, but you know what, Pennsylvania? He'll be against it very soon because his party is totally against it. Maybe the biggest statement in terms of business, that's the biggest statement.
Okay.
Because basically what he's saying is he is going
to
destroy the oil industry. Okay. Will you remember that, Texas? Will you remember that, Pennsylvania, Oklahoma?
Vice President Biden, let me give you 10 seconds to respond.
Ohio.
3. Vaaliväittelyssä käytiin kiivasta debaattia rasismista ja mustien asemasta Yhdysvalloissa. Biden hyökkäsi Trumpia vastaan syyttämällä tätä yhdeksi nykyajan rasistisimmaksi presidentiksi.
Started off his campaign coming down the escalator saying he's going to get rid of those Mexican rapists. He's banned Muslims because they're Muslims. He has moved around and made everything worse across the board.
My relationships with all people, I think I have great relationships with all people. I am the least racist person in this room. I can't even see the audience because it's so dark, but I don't care who's in the audience. I'm the least racist person in this room.
Nobody has done more for the black community than Donald Trump.
Abraham Lincoln here is one of the most racist presidents we've had in modern history. He pours fuel on every single racist fire. Said where you're Abraham
that,
Lincoln.
No, where did that... No, no.
You said,
I said, not since Abraham Lincoln has anybody done what I've done for the black community.
And I'm saying...
I didn't say I'm Abraham Lincoln. I said, not since Abraham Lincoln has anybody done what I've done for the black community.
Kaksi. Väittelyssä keskusteltiin molempien osapuolien kytköksistä ulkomaihin. Trump väitti Bidenin olevan korruptoitunut poliitikko ja nosti taas esiin Bidenin pojan Hunter Bidenin kyseenalaiset liiketoimet Ukrainassa. Biden muistutti Trumpin kiinalaisesta pankkitilistä ja syytti Trumpia veljeilystä diktaattoreiden kanssa.
We learned that this president paid 50 times the tax in China, has a secret bank account with China, does business in China, and in fact is talking about me taking money. I have not taken a single penny from any country whatsoever, ever. Number two, this is a president, I have released all of my tax returns, 22 years, go look at them, 22 years of my tax return. You have not released a single solitary year of your tax return. What are you hiding?
I prepaid millions and millions of dollars in taxes, number one. Number two, I don't make money from China, you do. I don't make money from Ukraine, you do. I don't make money from Russia. You made $3.5 million, Joe, and your son gave you. They even have a statement that we have to give 10% to the big man. You're the big man, I think. I don't know. Maybe you're not. But you're the big man, I think. Your son said we have to give 10% to the big man. Joe, what's that all about? It's terrible.
Vice President Biden, there have been questions about the work your son has done in China and for a Ukrainian energy company when you were vice president. In retrospect, was anything about those relationships inappropriate or unethical?
Nothing was unethical. Here's what the deal.
You know what? North Korea, we're not in a war. We have a good relationship. You know, people don't understand. Having a good relationship
Trump,
with leaders of other countries
is a
good
thing. We have a lot of questions to get to.
Not
your
like
response.
Saying we had a good relationship with Hitler before he, in fact, invaded Europe, the rest of Europe. Come on.
Yksi. Molemmat ehdokkaat toistivat samoja asioita useaan kertaan. Trump sanoi, ettei Biden ole tehnyt mitään asioita ollessaan varapresidenttinä.
He was there for 47 years. He didn't do it. Did nothing. You guys did nothing. You have done nothing. Why didn't you get it done? You got nothing done. Why didn't you do it? Why didn't you get it done? You had 8 years with Obama. You know why, Joe? Because you're all talk and no action. Right.
Biden taas huokaili come on vaaliväittelyn ajan.
Come on. Come on, fool. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Give me a break. Oh God.
Yhdysvaltain presidentin vaalit huipentuvat 3. marraskuuta. Tilaa Hesari ja seuraa vaaleja YouTube-kanavaltamme.